session. Can anyone give the recap of the previous session till where we stopped the previous session? Anyone? I don't want the same persons to be repeating. It would be good if I get answers from anyone else.
In previous class, we discussed about strategy to reduce labor turnover and
yes.
its conclusion about it. And then we started about staffing, recruitment and selection. And we saw the roles of staffing and what are the factors affecting it. And then we saw about the sources of recruitment, whether it is internal or external. And then about the selection process. And finally, at last, we discussed about interest of employees and management.
Okay.
And motivation.
Motivation, yeah. We stopped till with motivation. Thank you so much, Nirbhay Singh. Okay. I think he has given a brief talk about the previous sessions, like what are the topics we covered in the previous class. We started with the strategies of labor turnover and we moved on finally to our staffing recruitment process and how this process actually takes place when an organization is going to hire an employee. And once after that is done, we started with the motivation, the topic called motivation. So let me share the screen. Okay. So I wanted all of you to stay muted, and these are the ground rules for all the classes. I wanted all of you to stay muted. If I'm running out of network connectivity, kindly let me know. And once the end of the session, if you have any doubts, let's discuss regarding the doubts. And if you have any other queries also, we'll discuss. Okay. So we saw what is motivation. So let me again go with the slide. Motivation is nothing but the internal and external factors that stimulate desire and energy in people to be continually interested, and you have to get committed to a work. That's nothing but getting, like someone or something is helping you to get motivated, get committed to a work, a role or a subject, or to make an effort or to attain a goal. Motivating people is about getting them to move in the direction which is required in order to achieve a result. You are put under a job. You're working under a team where all are performing good, but you are lagging somewhere. That may be due to a number of reasons. That may be a personal reason or maybe a professional reason. But though your co-workers, if they are helping you, telling that, okay, that's not an issue. Come, let's focus. Let's target on our objectives. If someone is there behind you to support, definitely you'll be feeling motivated and you will start working on your objectives. It is a goal-directed behavior. According to Stephen R. Robbins, motivation is defined as the willingness to exert high levels of effort. You have it's nothing but you perform in the normal level. If someone is motivating, or you are getting motivated, or you're getting inspired by some other persons or any resource persons, definitely your level of working, the energy will be like exerted to the higher level. Definitely you'll be interested to work more. Next, the nature and importance of motivation. So why and how people are getting motivated? If they like, we should always accomplish our task. If we are lagging, definitely we should concentrate on our goals and we should accomplish the task. So we need some people to motivate. That may be your supervisor, your manager, your managing director, or your co-workers. Anyone who's there, they should make you motivated to cover the task. Motivated employees helps the organization to survive. Motivated employees are more productive, increases the output of the firm. If an employee is getting motivated, he is motivated, he is performing good. Performance is good because his job commitment, his involvement in the job is the maximum. So definitely he'll be able to come out with the maximum output. As an individual, he'll be able to put the maximum output. So like when a number of members working in a team, then it'll going to be team motivation. Individual or team motivation definitely will help to put the maximum output of that particular team, which directly or indirectly going to increase the output of the entire organization. Approach of the belongingness of the firm. Process of motivation, we already saw this. It's nothing but you establish one goal. So you fix the goal. Based upon the goal, you have to focus your actions. You have to take actions and work accordingly to attain the goal and the needs. Needs is nothing but you have to make the basic requirements or the fulfillments of that particular organization. Process of motivation. Needs creates wants and desires to achieve or obtain something. This sentence means a lot. Needs, you are in a need. The organization is in need. Like your organization needs an annual turnover of 1,000 crores or 100 crores. That situation, definitely you should have some desire to achieve that objective and certain objective and goals you'll be fixing. That you have to achieve it. Goals are established based on the desires and wants. So based upon the target only you can fix your goal. Only then you can start working on the goal. Actions are taken based on the goals in order to attain it. If the goals are not achieved, what will happen? If you're not achieving the goal, if you're not working properly, if you're not sticking to the timetable of your own, you're not working. So your task will not be accomplished. Your goals will not be achieved. So which in turn that is going to be directly affecting your productivity of the firm in which you're working. The same action is likely to be repeated. This process of repeating successful behavior or actions is called reinforcement or law of effect. So we have the types of motivation. There are two different types of motivation. This has been identified by Haysburg, a professor called Haysburg, where he has defined motivation has been classified into two different classifications, intrinsic motivation and extrinsic motivation. Intrinsic is nothing but getting motivated by an individual. He or she started getting motivated by their own. Extrinsic is nothing but the external parameters. That may be a co-worker, that may be the supervisor, that may be the manager, that may be the subordinate, any one external parameter that can influence you. Intrinsic motivation, the self-generated factors that influence people to behave in a particular way. So you will be progressing. It is good always to progress as an employee. You can mark your own progress, whether you're working good or bad. When you start progressing or monitoring, so you can consider, so weekly 5 days you're working. So if you draw a bar chart of 5 days, you can note whether you are up, down, up, down. Similarly, you can progress it for either 6 months or for 1 year or for the particular target of your objective. That may be that your project, the organization has been started a project for 2 to 3 years. So for the particular three years, like literally you can plot a graph, you can put it as n is equal to 1. You can mark it literally for 2 years, literally for third year. And at the end of third year, you will be able to monitor whether your progress is ups, downs, or it is like this, or at the third year you have increased like this. You can monitor your own individual progress. Whenever you're getting low, definitely you can see your graph and you can say, oh my God, I'm getting low. I should work on, I should still work better. Only then I'll be like, you'll be having your basic requirements as an individual. You need your promotions, you need your hikes, you need your incentives. Similarly, you need your better goods. That's right. Because as you people are growing, definitely we'll be requiring our personal needs. To satisfy our personal needs, we definitely want our promotions. We need our height. So all those things we require. So in order that you have to focus more. So day by day, when you're joining an organization by the end of 0 year, you're joining today. From here till 2 years, your performance will be increasing. From 2 years to 20 years, definitely your performance will be increasing. Whereas your salary also will be increasing. If you produce more, if your output is more, definitely you'll be awarded more. These factors includes responsibility. From the position, you're starting at this point. From here, if your position is gradually increasing at this, so probably this may take 20 years. So in this 20 years, you will be getting yourself, you can recognize yourself more responsible, like you will be sticking on to your work, you will be more committed, you will be more involved to your job, you will be finally getting so much of satisfaction. So all those things will be covered in intrinsic motivation. Scope to use and develop skill and abilities. Somewhere or there, you are lagging here. If you are lagging here or here, you can sit and analyze where you are actually lagging and what are the parameters that will help you to increase yourself. If you don't know any coding or if you don't know any software, you need to analyze any structure immediately, or if there is any update, you need to learn that. So you have to develop the skill and abilities. That situation, you can take your extra time for preparing or learning or understanding the concepts of that particular software or any other extracurricular things. You can, whichever is required for your objective, you can learn that, you can develop your skill. Interesting and challenging work, so that you can take, so you are able to do a normal work. So you wanted to explore yourself, you can take some interesting and challenging work so that you'll be interested to put your maximum there, and that will help you, and that will pave the way for the opportunity for advancements. Definitely, though you are a planner or you are a designer, you are performing well. Finally, based upon the output you are producing, your supervisors and the entire team will be watching you. They'll be monitoring. They'll be providing you with more opportunities to explore. That will take you to the next advanced position. Extrinsic motivation. Extrinsic motivation is nothing but the external parameters. So that will help you to get motivated. So what is done to or for people to motivate them? This includes rewards. So the external parameters, as I told, the pay, the price, the monitor, the promotion. So these are nothing but the external parameters. That will help you to stay motivated. Punishments. So if you do not perform well in that situations, or you are violating any regulations of the organization or rules or policies of the organization, that time you will be taken disciplinary action, withholding, they'll hold the pay of yours where they're not provided, criticism, those things also will happen. Extrinsic motivation can have an immediate and powerful effect, but it will not necessarily last long. That's true. It's like there are so many different types of people where, like, once they get their salary, they'll be like very happy. They'll be producing their maximum output for some 15 to 20 days. At the end of the month, they'll not be performing well because their pocket goes empty. They'll not have mind to work. Some of them will take it as a challenge, telling that, okay, my pocket goes empty, so I have to put the maximum to get the salary soon. So they'll be working on, if you monitor their progress will be like this. Till the end of the month. It was in the first manner, in the first case. The first case, it will be like this. The performance will be going like this, the declining manner. This is up to 15 days. So it depends upon the individuals. These are the external parameters, and it is applicable to every individual. So we have two different motivation theories. So we saw what is motivation, what are the different types of motivations, intrinsic and extrinsic motivation, and we have most influencing theories for motivation. We have two different theories. One is Maslow's need hierarchy theory, and the next is Herzberg's two factor theory. So we have two different theories. First is Maslow's need hierarchy theory. So everything is based upon the need. You need money to survive. That's the reason you go for the job. You go for the job, you get some 20,000 or 30,000 pay. What you do? Your requirements are growing each and every year. So probably you have joined for 20,000. After 5 years, you're getting only 22,000 or 23,000. By this end of 5 years, your requirements, your needs, you are going in a bike, you are planning to go for a car, or your requirements are increasing, your personal requirements. You do have a family, you need to take care of them, their medical expenses, their educational expenses. So everything will be growing at that time. It's your need. Your need is fixed big, definitely you will be able to put the maximum. So based upon the need only, your performance will be. Abraham Maslow's organized 5 major types of human needs into an hierarchy. Like he has given a table like this, listing out all the 5 parameters. The need hierarchy illustrates Maslow's concept of people satisfying their need in a specific order, from the top to bottom approach. Theory states that when a lower level need is satisfied, the next highest becomes dominant. So you need some low level. What is your low level? Probably you need your basic necessities, food, shelter, clothing. So you get some 20,000, you are able to rent a house. You can take care of your expenses, your food, your accommodation, everything comes under there. So your basic low level is done. So next, what you need to buy a bike, or probably you need to travel through any transport, you need that. So definitely you'll be looking after the next hierarchy, what you want. So once the bike is done, so probably after 5 years, you'll be thinking of the car. So like this, your needs increases. Next, the highest becomes the dominant, and the individual's attention is turned to satisfying this higher need. So once you're done with the low level, you move on to the next higher level. Once your second level is done, probably you'll be looking after your third level, and you'll be moving on. So these are the different 5 different needs which they are classifying. First is your basic needs. where you will be taking care of your breathing, food, sleep. So for this, food and accommodation. Next is your safety parameters, where you need security, you need employment job security, your healthcare and property. And next, you will be moving on to your personal needs, your family requirements, your friendship needs, whatever thing you need. Probably you may have, after 10 years or 15 years later, you will be having your anniversary needs or your family needs. That may be varying based upon the as age grows, your personal and your relationship needs will be increasing. That time you have to focus on that. So the basic, you will be done with this when you're joining the job. After 5 years, you will be done with this. And after 10 years, you will be done with this. Like, this is the hierarchy where it is keeping on increasing. And finally, it is esteem. Esteem is nothing but self-esteem, confidence, achievements, respect. So once you're done, you're right now in 10 years, meanwhile, you might have gained your self-esteem, your image in your organization might have been built up very high, your confidence level by this 10 years of tenure, your achievements, the respect you have gained, this must have definitely grown. And finally, you go for self-acquisition, for where you get the moral, creativity and openness. So this are going to be the basic five basic motivation here. Concepts of five, it is the Maslow's need hierarchy theory. They have five different types of classifications from the bottom to top. You have like this, from the bottom to top approach. So all these are the five different parameters. Next is Herzberg's two factor theory. Frederick Herzberg developed the two-factor theory of motivation based on the satisfiers and the dissatisfiers. So you have two different factors. One is the satisfier and one is dissatisfier. I'm getting 20,000 paid. I'm satisfied with my job. But another one is getting the same 20,000 or 25,000. He's not satisfied with the job. Probably his need may be higher than what he gets. That may be the reason. Or though he works better, the working hours is not comfortable, the working environment, there may be n number of parameters that makes him get dissatisfied or not involving him to do his job. Satisfiers are motivators associated with job satisfaction. Those whoever are satisfiers, they are nothing but they are committed to their job, they are performing it well, and finally they are, at the end of the day, they are satisfied with their job. While dissatisfiers are motivators associated with hygiene or maintenance. Satisfiers includes achievement, responsibility, advancement, and recognition. Satisfiers are all intrinsic motivators. That's true. Once they started motivating him or her, their own self, then they do not require any external parameters to motivate. So already they are motivated, they are performing better. Finally, what will happen? They'll produce good output. They'll be getting good income on fine day. Probably they'll be getting their promotion space, hikes, their health coverages. All those things will be won by the organization. They'll be bearing all those things. Dissatisfiers. If someone is dissatisfied, probably your friend is not feeling or he's not feeling comfortable in this particular environment due to the pay, or the policies of the organization, or the working hours, or the workloads, there may be different working conditions. Probably everything is fine, but the supervisor is he and Hitler always shouting or always charging against him. That situation, he will not be able to work peacefully. So he will be falling under the category of dissatisfier. Dissatisfier are extrinsic motivators and include a company's policy and administration, such as supervision, peers, working conditions and salary. So this may be the varying parameters. Any one of the above parameters can affect, and that can cause him to be the dissatisfied or where he is not getting job satisfaction. The two-factor theory implies that the managers must stress upon guaranteeing the adequacy of the hygiene factors to avoid employees' dissatisfaction. Am I audible?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. The managers must make sure that the work is stimulating and rewarding so that the employees are motivated to work and perform better. If someone is letting me know that you are lagging, you should work hard only, then you'll be getting your pay. If someone is sitting and talking to you, like, you should not take it as an advice. You should take that they are motivating you to do perform better. Only then you have to concentrate on your goals. Once you're accomplishing your goals on the right time, the maximum productivity, definitely you will be awarded a better hike. So, methods of motivating employees, that may be rewards. If someone is performing well, that time you are providing better pay, or that maybe you are providing any for achievements, you are providing any cash prizes, or you are speaking them, or you're praising them in before their co-workers. That time they'll be getting cheered and they'll be performing better. Although the co-workers, they'll also think, okay, if I perform better, I also will be appreciated. So my talent will be recognized. So they also will be getting motivated by seeing others. They expect that good job performance lead to organizational goal attainment, which in turn leads to satisfying their individual goals or needs. If you're satisfied to a job, I'm satisfied with this job. Okay, I'm right now teaching. I'm satisfied with this job. Simultaneously, I'm doing research. This is comfortable for me. So all my organizational goals are done. I'm doing good. So if I'm like once my if I'm professionally satisfied only, I'll be able to satisfy my individual goals or the needs. So okay, you can take it either way. To satisfy my personal or the individual goals or needs, I'm working to do this. Or you can take it anyway because both are interconnected. Challenging jobs. This is done through job enrichment. Job enrichment means building motivators like opportunities for achievement in the job by making it more interesting and challenging. Like one, if a team of 5 or 10 are working, someone is performing excellent task, and definitely they'll be given some opportunities to explore more, to take up some challenging projects which the organization has. And if they are doing good, their job enrichment, if they're going good, they'll be taken to the next level with the good pay, the good recognition, the promotions. And it will help to develop as an individual as well. Using merit pay. A merit rise is a salary increase, usually permanent, that is based on the employee's individual performance. That's right. If you perform better, definitely you'll be paid good. It is a continuing increment rather than a single payment like a bonus. Relying heavily on the merit rewards can be a problem because the reinforcement benefits of the merit pay is usually only determined per, like this they do know, like every year and once they give you their merit pay or the extra pay they'll be giving you, annual increment pay or the grant pay they'll be giving you. That will be given, though it is given yearly, if some important task has been accomplished, you're working on, your entire organization is working on a project, there is an issue that to be rectified very immediately. In that situation, if you are helping them out, they are done with it, the issues are solved, you are getting the productivity, definitely they'll be awarding you then and there. Only then, if they are avoiding you with the bonus for you or with the hike for you, definitely you will be interested. Seeing that the co-workers, also the subordinates, they'll be taking you as a role model and they'll be working on to give their maximum. Using spot awards. A spot award is one given to an employee as soon as the notable performance is observed. So once he is performing at the best, the maximum is given, so definitely he'll be awarded the spot. So based upon the spot awards, like though it is surprising for him that it will be like still motivating, though he is performing best also, still it will be motivating him to perform to the maximum. And this will help him to create a bond at the job satisfaction level. He'll be more involved to this job and he'll be emotionally attached to that organization. These awards are consistent with the principles of motivation because they are contingent on the good performance and are awarded immediately. Using skill-based pay. With skill-based pay, employees are paid for their range. For whatever the range is nothing but the based upon the designation, they are paid. Based upon the experience, they are paid. Based upon the educational qualification, the skills. So all this based upon the knowledge, background or the skills they possess based upon this only, the pays are classified. With skill-based pay, employees are paid for the range, the depth of knowledge, the type of the skills and knowledge they are capable of using rather than for the job they currently hold. The reward is a formal and concrete recognition that the person can do more challenging jobs as well. So next is our welfare measures. Not only this, not only our motivation, other than this, if you provide them some welfare measures to take care of their needs, that time still they'll be committed to their job. So how to take care of them? You can provide them the basic needs like transport, canteen. Though as an individual, probably you may have in some city, your project is going on in some city where the employees has to travel some 35 kilometers or 40 kilometers, probably 50, 60 kilometers are even happening nowadays. That situation, what they need some transport arrangement. If transport arrangement is provided, definitely they'll be comfortable. They'll not leave your organization. Like they'll be still committed to your, they'll stick on to your organization. If your organization, unless the organization leaves them, they'll not leave the organization. Probably canteen. So those are the basic requirements. They need canteen. Probably they'll be from long distance. They need to carry their food. So it would be good if they have some canteen or crutches. If it's going to be a women employee, if they have someone to take care of their kids, so it will be good for them to work peacefully. So during the lunch breaks or then and there, they can go have a visit so that they'll be working peacefully. So it would not be always a mindset living a newborn child or a 6 months to 1 year child living in some 60, 70 kilometers and sitting here and working. That will not be a peaceful mindset. So that is also one of the welfare measures. Group dynamics. Counseling. So if group dynamics will help us to develop not only as an individual, also as a team. Counseling for those who are lagging, motivation that should happen, frequent seminars, workshops should be it should be framed or compiled regularly, and that will help the laborers or the employees to still motivated, stick on to their objectives and fulfill the task. Proper leadership, not only based upon the proper leadership. We saw about the managers, about our leaders. We saw all those main role, persons who are performing their main roles. So leaders, managers, they are the bosses of our projects. They should be good. And the level of communication, whatever you communicate to them, that should reach the managing director in a proper manner. There should not be any communication gap. Research in personal and organizational problems. If there is any organizational problems, might be the organizational cultural issues, because people are working under from different cultures, there may be some organizational cultural issues that should be taken care. Behavioral issues. All the people will not be behaving the same manner. It is based upon all the emotions, their mood swings. So all those things should be considered. So many multiple researches are going on the aspects of the personal and the organizational problems. That should be like rectified, and only the maximum welfare should be given to the employees. So once an employee is completely satisfied, his requirements, his needs, his problems in the professional aspects, all those things are particularly taken care of, that situation, he'll never have an idea of skipping out, or he'll never have an idea of postponing the task. He'll be doing it then and there. So we are end of this topic. So let me move to the next topic. So let me stop share. Do you have any doubts to this motivation theory? Do you have any doubts? Any doubts? Your attendance will be strictly monitored. So I wanted all of you to be on time regularly to the class. Is it okay? I'm happy to see 115 students here, but I'm still sad 10 of them are missing. This is the case for every class. probably from 10 to 20 people are absent in every day's class. I don't want this to happen. Thereafter, I request you all to be on time to the class. Probably you you'll be knowing that we'll be having the class for some 40 maximum the time of 45 minutes. So I wanted you all to attend. Please do ensure that you maintain your proper attendance. Yes. Okay. Do you have any doubts till this? If you have any doubts, let's discuss now. If you don't have any doubts, let's move on to the next topic. Yes, let me know.
No doubts, ma'am.
Okay, so let us move to the next topic. Our next topic is all related to the safety laws. Safety laws of an organization. So how important is safety? You are working in the construction field. How do you think you should be safe, right? If you're safe, if you're healthy, only you'll be able to work. What are the things you like? You do think as the basic safety things they require in the organization, the construction sector. Anyone of you can share your own ideas. Right now, you all are working in a construction sector, probably in any different types of departments or disciplines you are working. But you are working under the roof of a construction firm. What safeties do you require? Not only you, any individual, what are the safety measures they do require?
Safety helmets.
Yes.
Safety helmets, shoes for the workers.
Yeah, stay with helmets. Yes. Come on, quick answers.
Ma'am, while working with machines, we need to be careful.
Yes, you need to be very careful when you're working with machineries. So for that need, we require good quality machineries as well as skilled person to operate that particular machinery. Okay. Any other safety measures? Is only helmet for enough for you? If helmet is there, everything is done. Your head
safety
is
net.
Yeah.
Safety nets.
Safety needs.
Nets, ma'am. Net one.
Okay, safety nets. That's true. Yeah, throughout your structure, you need your safety nets. You're constructing a multi-storied building. Definitely, you need safety nets.
Ma'am, insurance.
Insurance. Good. That may be your health insurances. Also, any other needs? You don't want any safety, only your job, your salary, your commitment towards your job, only this is enough. You don't want any other types of safety.
Protective equipment.
Protective? Repeat it, pardon. Protective environment. I don't get you.
Them like gloves and glasses and all.
Yes, gloves. You need your glasses. Okay. Fine.
Special kind of.
Yes. Repeat it.
A special kind of shoes which can protect from.
Yeah. Special kind of hard shoes which doesn't damage your legs. That's true. Safety shoes. You require all those things in your. Also, you require sign boards. Do you agree? Do you require sign boards in your construction sector? Work under progress. Watch your steps. Stays near. Have you ever heard of this? Any things of what I told now? Watch your steps. That is a signboard. Watch your steps. Because the level may not be good. Stairs near, which indicates that there will be a staircase near your platform. And wet surface, newly concreted which means it has been concreted just now. You should not go put your leg inside that. There will be multiple signboards indicating it is danger. You should not go there. Wear your helmets. Follow safety measures. So all those things are there because we need to construct a house with maximum safety. While constructing, it should be maximum safe for us. If we are safe only, we'll be able to produce a good, we'll be able to deliver a good quality product. A product here represents our buildings. So, importance of safety. The construction industry employing the largest labor force in the country has accounted for about 11% of all occupational injuries and 20% of all death resulting from occupational accidents. So, it is then and there common nowadays hearing that people were working immediately, one of them or two of them, they fell down, proper care was not taken in that particular project site, and there was a fatal case. So, this has been become common now, which means the particular organization is not taking care of the safety measures of the employees. The cost of accidents is expensive. However, economic cost is not only the reason for which a contractor should be conscious of the safety. Not only if someone dies, only we should not be, the contractor should not be worried that, oh my God, if he dies, I should pay some 10,000 or 10 lakhs or 15 lakhs for him. They should be, they should make sure proper safety throughout their working stages. Only then people will be peaceful there to work. What happens then and there, common for quality also. You are constructing some 15, 16 floors immediately, you are in the top 14th floor, immediately your 15th floor roof collapses and falls, what will happen? So proper safety and quality should be ensured as always. The reasons for considering safety, that may be humanitarian concerns or economic reasons. For humanitarian concerns, when the accident happens, the resulting suffering from the injured workers and their families is difficult to quantify in economic terms. The contractor should never ignore if he has insurance against this accidents. Probably most of the contractors, they do hide telling that they don't have any insurances, but they do have, but they are in the plan of just taking away that amount. Economic reasons. Even if a contractor has insurance, he will find out that the cost of the accidents will come out of his own pocket through an increase in premiums. In addition, there are other indirect costs that results from accidents. What happens, you are a top firm in the city, you are some 20 years, 30 years old, well-reputed organization, firm, a construction firm, you are building a multi-story building. What happens, suddenly some two or three of them are dying because of any accident taking place. What happens? So the entire organization's reputation also goes down. It goes down because the organization doesn't take proper care for the employees. There should be a safety team always. There should be an ambulance ready at your work site always. Because when it is engaging some 500 or 600 people working in a multi-project, big project, that time there should be emergencies handled. There should be people to take care of the emergency situations. The direct and indirect cost of the accidents. So we will classify what are the direct cost and indirect cost. Our direct cost are going to be the medical care expenses for injured, workmen's compensation cost, insurance premium increases, replacement cost of equipment and materials damaged. So if any equipment is damaged or any parts of the machines are damaged, that you're going to, you'll be replacing it. Facility repair and cleanup. Fee for legal counsel. Indirect cost. Our indirect cost is nothing but slowdown in operation. So definitely someone is dying there, definitely will not be able to start the work immediately. There will be some police inquiries. So that will be taking care. That will also tend to slow down your operations. Decrease in morale, which affects the productivity. Productive time lost. Probably the co-workers, they will not be feeling comfortable to work in this environment. Their productivity time will be lost. Mentally, they cannot work peacefully. They also will be scared. No? If this has happened to person A, B, that will definitely happen to me. So they'll be worried regarding that. administrative work associated with the accidents, loss of clients. That's true. Your organization, the reputation of the organization or the firm will be damaged, which directly reflects the loss of clients. So they'll be the, your clients will be scared. No, my God, well, constructing itself, so many persons have died. What will happen if after constructed? So they'll think of so many things. So overtime necessitated by work slowdown. What happens? So probably if there is some death case in your work site due to any accidents, they'll be conducting some 15 days or 20 days of inquiry where you'll not be. You have your houses to be handed over by March 30. You don't have enough time. Probably it is 15th. So 15 days they'll be taking some inquiries. You'll not be work done. So this 45 days work should be completed within 30 days. So what you will do? You will be going on for overtime work. That is more like continuous works from morning one batch and night one batch. You'll be working overtime necessitated. So that is necessitating the double amount you have to start working. Overtime definitely labor will be bargaining for over expenses. Laws and regulations. Do you have the next class at 12:30? Okay, so let me stop with this slide. Laws and regulations as per different acts and laws. The employer should look after the safety of the employee. Violation of these laws will be subjected to punishment. Organizational image, as I told, probably gaining that reputation or that recognition for the entire 20 to 30 years is not an easy job. So much of hard work, so much of quality will let you that good recognition. What will happen if there is some accidents taking place, your entire recognition goes down? So definitely there will be no clients with you. Your projects will be dropped. There will be no investors. There will be like all your teams will be like getting like it will be into a total trap. A good safety record can produce higher moral and productivity and stronger employee loyalty. So you are running a 30 years old firm. You don't have any accidents taking place. Your safety measures are very good. That time you will be able to go with good productivity and good quality. That will automatically develop a good reputation among the clients also. It will also improve the company's public image and therefore make it easier to acquire negotiated jobs. Stop with this. Do you have any doubts to this?
No.
Any doubts?
No.
Okay, proper working equipment, yes. I'm sorry, just now I saw the chat box. Okay, thank you, students. If you have any doubt, you can stay. If you don't have any doubts, you can leave the meeting.